Welcome back to Wasteland 2. It is time to go to Darwin Village. Because apparently there's a chance of finding a cure for the doc's cancer there. And also the mysterious logbook that it turns out belonged to Hellraiser mentioned Darwin Village. So, given all of that and the fact that my team is pretty well equipped and we just found the radiation suit, the good one, means I think it's time to go to Darwin Village. Because from what the reports said, it sounded like the place was probably going to be filled with a lot of radiation, so I didn't want to go there until I had some good rad suits. And now that we have them, let's get going. Question is, though, which way do I want to go? I guess I'll just head up to the rail nomads camp and then head over to the right. Yeah, this looks open here. Not actually sure if it is, but it looks open. So yeah, let's head up. Holy crap, I just realized we're almost out of water. Let's go stop here. I wonder what happens if you get to zero water. Do you just, like, instantly die? No, I don't want to fight. Go away. Now we can get through this radiation, no problem. Was there anything I wanted to stop at the camp for? I know I was going to deliver a letter that one person wanted me to deliver back at the Citadel, but I convinced him to just quit the Rangers and just go to his... Was it his sister? Or his wife? Something like that. So now that that's done, I don't think I actually need to go there. Okay. Yep.
Hey! This is Holiday at the store. I got everything you need and plenty of it, so come on down! Unless you're a teenager or a goddamn hobo. No shoplifters. Stay the hell out of my store.
Yeah, telling shoplifters not to come to your store, that'll work. Because we know that people that are criminals like to obey what people tell them to do. And why is the world flashing? Everything just, like, disappeared for a second. Run away. There's gotta be something good here. What's here? There's gotta be something, right? No? There's like a crater here. Huh. Alright, we kinda need water now. Ooh. Oh, wow. Actually, I don't think I needed these really good radiation suits. I think I could have been okay with what I had before. Let's take a look around this place. Let's go to super speed. Ooh, what's this? Ah, there's a cache. What the hell is that? Man, I don't know if that's like a number station sort of thing, or if that's some sort of an intercepted communication involving the robots, maybe? It's creepy. That's okay. Oh. They're definitely harder here, because there's only a 50% chance to escape. No! Alright, I'll kick y'all's asses. ...125 hit points. You know, I used to be scared of people that had 125 hit points. And now I laugh at your faces. Wait till I get a piece of Vax. The dude that likes to look like he's gonna shoot and then for some reason doesn't. He's an impotent robot, just shoots blanks. We don't need to be too tactical about this. I'll set our people up. I guess I am being tactical about it, but... oh well. Oh, right. Can't save. Aw, oh, come on. I shot first. There's no need to burst fire. Move on up. Let's move over, actually. Yes. Okay, let's see if Vax can actually do something. Ooh! You actually can shoot. No, my metal friend! Actually, wait a minute, Vax, didn't you shout, like, kill all humans before? Maybe I want you to die. Crap, I didn't mean to skip her turn. Oh well. Yeah. That does not do much damage, but it looks really, really cool. 44%? Nah, I'm just gonna save my ammo. Oh my god! Aim is so bad. No, Vax! His aim is so fucking bad. He just like shot one. Didn't one hit? I think one hit him, right? Hold on. Yeah, look at this. Takayuki is raked by a Red Scorpion Heavy Gunner's withering fire, causing 9 points of damage. He was hit once, and then all the rest of the rounds hit the dirt and the rock. You incompetent motherfucker. I was gonna say Miami. I'll just use shotgun and melee. Ah. Hey, wait a minute. Who are you? Wastelander. Was that a hostage, maybe? Alright, I guess I'll finish you off. Well, that was surprising. Your aim is so bad! Shotguns are so bad, too. That was just a knife. I cut him in half with a knife. Takayuki, you're stronger than... you don't know your own strength. Let's see what Vax dropped. 6th shell. That sounds kind of neat. Unfortunately, it's junk. This plastic shell comes from a dead synth's head. Oh, it's a dead person. Yeah, there's a bunch of dead people around here. Alright, so what is up with y'all? What? You can go... Okay, you're welcome. I apparently saved your life. Maybe these people are more grateful. Or not. You should have been here sooner. Sorry. You're welcome. Okay, this person's actually grateful. Holy crap, Darwin Village is really, really small. Look at that. It's so tiny. Now I'm a little bit worried about what might be here. Because this was the former residence of... some crazed doctor or something, right? Oh! Okay. There's... zombies, essentially. Time has not been kind to this place. The buildings are fire-blackened ruins, and it's knee-deep in shifting sand. It's also overrun by plague-ridden zombies, but that's new. Whoa. If I'm not misreading that, these things do a lot of damage. Does that say 40 to 50? I'm pretty sure that's their damage. Okay, so they have low hit points, very low armor, but they do a lot of damage. So we want to kill them before they get to us. Gotcha. Well, in that case, let's set up a firing line. And Takayuki, you remind me why melee sucks. I really want to replace him with someone who isn't melee. Technically, there is Scotchmo, who's a shotgunner. I believe that's my only other member that I can get that does not have melee, but... I don't want another shotgunner, because they kind of suck. I'd rather have melee than another shotgun. Yeah, we're just gonna hold our ground. Wanted to move her out of the way. I don't want to move you forwards, but you're useless since you are melee unless you get close, so. There's something wrong with those mutants. Besides being mutants, I mean. Okay. What do you mean? They're really, really slow. Is there a way to speed up turns? I'm just gonna go make a cup of coffee. Maybe do my taxes? Shotgunner's also useless if she doesn't move up. I really don't want to move you forwards. This seems like a bad idea, and I'm worried that you might get the plague. See what happens. Accidentally skipped a turn again. Well, I was gonna hold our ground, but now that I've moved everybody up, I guess I might as well keep going. Ooh, if I move forwards one more, I might be able to get three of them. No, it's not quite wide enough. Or is it? Nope, it's not. Let's move out of their plaguey grip. There's no T at the end of that word. And we can save our ammo. Wonder what they have on them. Oh. IVs? A transmorpher?
Copy, Echo One. Congratulations, Echo.
Got a couple levels up. Harper, how many do you have? 5? Not quite enough for what I want. Theodore? Ooh, 6. Medic, assault rifles, leadership. He's so good at this stuff, I almost want to upgrade his assault rifle skill. Like, he doesn't really need more leadership, or kiss-ass, or field medic. I was not going to focus at all on combat skills, but honestly, at this point, I think I can spare it. Make him suck a little bit less. This place is eerie. It's a ghost town. Well, a plague town. And there's more. Are those barrels of toxic waste? Okay, Theodore, you should be a little bit better at shooting now. If anybody was actually in range. Yeah, these enemies are kind of perfect for Yulia, because they tend to get bunched up. I might even be able to hit four at one time. And probably just three. Make that two. They've never actually attacked us yet. They've tried to, but they've never actually managed to. Just a little bit too far away to get both. I'll save my ammo. What's the worst that could happen? Ow. My god. Cut off its head. We don't need ambush. Should be able to get up to Takayuki, but not quite kill him, and it's gonna trigger his... Oh, no, didn't trigger his ambush. Out of ammo. Angela. Oh, that's right. I think I need to distribute some ammo for the assault rifle. Yeah, so you're out of that. I think it was Harper that had a shit ton. Yeah, Harper's got a bunch. Theodore's got quite a bit. Well, I'll give you like 15 from him and 15 from him too. Yeah, there's just tons of toxic waste everywhere. Pickle jar. Who got the pickle jar? You did. Judging from the expiry date, is a miracle that Brian hasn't burned through the glass. Ew.
Copy, Echo One. Congratulations, Echo.
Helen, how many points? 6? Nice. Okay. Looks like perception is lagging behind, so let's go ahead and upgrade that. Ooh. What is this? Ah. It's probably the hatch to his laboratory. Laboratorium. Control panel is connected to the door. It looks like it requires a code. Have I been given a code? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Aw, the 9 doesn't fit. Now, if it requires a code, I can't hack it, right? Oh, wait a minute. I can. That's a hard... Wow, that's a really hard door, actually. That's my computer science skill, which is... Yeah, my computer science is level 7. So hold on, it's 62% chance, which means that it must be a challenge level 6. Yeah. Well, let's keep looking around. Maybe we don't need to hack it. Oh, I didn't even realize there's a gate there. It just loops around. Nothing but a lock. Yeah, this place is obviously pretty high level, right? Even though those enemies were really easy, you can see the fact that that thing is so hard to hack, and even this gate was fairly challenging. Oh, hey, what's this? Ooh! Free skill points. This obelisk looks like it was moved here, carefully, from somewhere else. Life is a dream of a butterfly, has been scratched into the stone. Crudely, but orderly. Huh. Is there anything else I missed? Doesn't seem so. And nobody's given me a code to this place, have they? Doesn't say anything about a code. I don't remember a code. So I guess I have to hack it. And if I mess it up, well, we're pretty damn screwed. I did just get a skill point. Oh! I just got a skill point. Guess where I'm gonna put it? Computer science! See if that's raised anybody up enough. Ooh, 6 points, nice. Could upgrade the brute force that I virtually never, ever, ever use. I suppose I will. Seems to be the one that's lagging behind. Okay. Alright, let's give Harper some room. Everybody stay back. He's got this. Come on, Harper. Don't mess this up, man. Ooh, it's a critical success. Nice. Alright, what the hell are we gonna find down here? You know what this is reminding me of? This is reminding me of Stalker. Going down into some old laboratory where they've done experiments. Hope I don't find any poltergeists. let's see. An ancient military facility. Firebombed into rubble, but it looks like somebody thought there was still something of value inside. There are fresh footprints in the sand that carpets the entranceway. The footprints look like they were made by metal feet. Everything in here was smashed and burned by professionals long ago, but it looks like they missed something, a hidden door in the back wall. It's open now, and recently. The metal of the door frame is the cleanest thing in the room. Wait, a hidden door in the back... Wait, you mean this? Doesn't look hidden. What are you talking about? That in no way looks hidden. I don't know... Why would you call that a hidden door? Okay, and... Oh! There's bodies in here. Alright, yeah, there's something else around here. In this room. Whoa. Oh! We now all have the plague. And it lasts forever. Flecks of foam form on the side of your mouth as the disease eats away at your brain. Oh, lovely. Well, we better find a cure. Hi. Are you patient zero? These mutants don't look diseased like the others do. They must have died before it spread. Oh, there's a robot. The monk is in several parts, chopped up by the axes and machetes of the mutants. Their strength must have been incredible to make a dent in his synthetic hide. The monk. The monk? Now, wasn't there, like, the Order of the Mad Monks or something like that that I'm going to try to find the radio message from? Like, I'm going to try to listen into their broadcasts to find the hole in the radiation wall? Is that what the Mad Monks are? They're robots? Or androids? Glass-doored, climate-controlled closets line the room, all filled with shelves of neatly labeled test tubes, and all still running. One cabinet is open, and one test tube is smashed on the floor, next to a dead metal monk. It wasn't what was in the test tube that killed the monk, however. It was hacked apart by the diseased mutants whose corpses surround it, and it hacked them apart, too. A mutual massacre. As you enter, there is a movement from behind the glass door of the closet at the back of the room. So is it that smashed test tube that spread this plague? Wait, I'm confused though. It says it wasn't what was in the test tube that killed the monks, however, it was hacked apart by the diseased mutants whose corpses surround it. So it says these are diseased mutants, but it says these mutants don't look diseased like the others do, they must have died before it spread. Well, I guess they are mutants, just not as far gone. I don't know. Oh my god. That's really, really hard. Can I upgrade my safecracking skill? I don't think I can. Nope. Oh, wow. It's level 7. 25%. Was it 25? It's 28%. My god, this is kind of a high level place. That must be a level 8 safe. Damn. I don't know if I want to touch that. What if I can't get inside of it? I could try blowing it up, I suppose. Whoa. There's a female mutant cowering inside a locked room. She's as twisted as the others, but does not look diseased. Can I talk with her? I need help. She can talk. What do you need? I jumped in here as soon as I saw the test tube drop. But now I've trapped myself. If I come out, I'll catch the plague. Just like the rest of us did. Just like you did when you walked in here. I need you to go into the maintenance room one floor below and flip the switch to turn on the air purifier. That will filter out the toxins in the air. Unfortunately, many of my mutant brothers and sisters are wandering around down there, and are crazed from the sickness. Even if I could go myself, I would never reach the lab. They would have torn me apart. But you, you can make it. You're well armed. When you find the switch for the purification system, flip it to turn it on. That will stop the toxins from spreading and cure my brothers and sisters. Wait, it'll cure them. So that means I don't want to kill them, right? Because I can save them. I know you'll have to kill a few of my people to get there, but please try to kill as few as possible. They can't help themselves. Wait, I don't understand, though. It'll stop the toxins from spreading and cure. How will purifying the air cure them? Wouldn't that just make it so they don't get sicker? But they're already sick. I mean, if clear air will stop the toxins from spreading and cure them, then wouldn't the people up above already have been cured? Because they're just in the open air. Obviously, there's no kind of toxins or whatever going around up above, because I would have caught the plague up above. I didn't. So, I don't understand. But okay. Okay, how far is she from leveling? She's pretty close. She's gonna get... How many skill points is she gonna get? 2 or 3? Actually, it doesn't even matter. Okay. Here's what I'm gonna do. I really want to see what's inside of this safe. Because the fact that it's so hard to get into it probably means it's very valuable. But the chance of critical failure is too great. So, given that Vulture's Cry is already pretty close to leveling, and she has 4 skill points right now, she's probably gonna level down here, and when she does, I'm gonna have enough skill points to upgrade her safecracking to level 8. So I'm gonna wait. I could just open this, couldn't I? And then she'd be screwed. Wait a minute, how long has she been down here? I mean, she has nothing to eat. When did this happen? Like, a day ago? Okay, so we want to kill as few as possible. I don't really have any way to sneak, though. A sheaf of papers are strewn across this desk. The topmost one reads, Memorandum. Once again, I must remind everyone that my name is Erwin Finster, not Erwin. Please, the work we are doing here will make history. We should at least try to get our spelling correct, so the textbooks will report the truth. Ooh, it's a quest item. For something. I don't even know what quest, though. Did I gain a quest by picking that up? A monitor display screen with the liquid crystal still intact, and the connecting wires neatly wound up. What a find. That's a turret. High-tech security system in lockdown mode. Oh, can hack it no problem, but let's try this method first. Numbers, letters, and strange symbols you don't recognize flash on the screen, giving off a faint green glow. The computer seems connected to the nearby door by a heavy coaxial cable. Access denied. Alrighty. So I can hack the door or the terminal. Let's hack the terminal. Whoa. Hello. A fine red line cuts across the hall. At either end, you can make out small mirrored laser emitters looking hooked to high-yield explosives. That's actually a really cool-looking laser line. It's actually surprisingly detailed. You can kind of see it move back and forth like there's dust particles in the air. You know, it's not just a perfectly smooth line. Cool. So I'm assuming I can disarm that? Yes. Yep, there's more. Probably one more, yep. They get harder and harder as you go on. Industrial airlock door, used to keep in things in and out things out. Secured with a passcode. I can hack it, no problem. But let's try our customary 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Damn it. I'll try 1. Is it 1? It's not 1. Oh boy. What? The hell? Did she mess up the disarming, or did she just walk into it? I think she just walked into it. Nice one, Yulia. I'm still using this super, the lowest level med bags, which don't heal very much. It's probably more. It's an odd place for this machinery. A massive chemical tank has fallen across the hallway. Unless you can clear it, there's no getting past. Ooh, listening closely, you can hear something bubbling and frothing inside. Whatever is in this tank, it's volatile and wants out. Ooh, it's leaking out the top. Look at that. What the fuck is inside of it? This place is just... it's like, a maze filled with traps, like... I feel like I'm playing somebody's... obstacle course. Alright. Well, it says unless you can clear it, there's no getting past. Can I use brute force to, like, push it? No. Hack it. Perception it? That didn't help. Heal it? No. Disarm it? No. Do I just have to blow it up? Repair? Whisper to it? I can't do anything to it. I think I just have to blow it up. Okay. Nice, Buckshot flies out in an ejaculation of death. Good job, Yulia. What the hell is this shit? This hallway has turned into a piece of modern art. Seems like doing that set off an attached trap. If anyone asks, you meant to do that, right? Yeah. Cool. What the hell? What is that stuff? And it's locked. My god. Trap after trap after trap. It's actually only got 150 hit points, and what the fuck are you? What in the hell? Little green blob dude with a doll in his hand. The fuck? What is that? Carefully examining the crate, finds a trap. Okay. Yeah, it looks like it has a stick of dynamite just sitting on the top of it. It's not a very well-concealed trap. Okay, so I just made it through hell here, but this is where I started. What's just this way? I don't know if I'm going the way I should go, or what? Is this thing gonna shoot me? I mean, it shows up red, so I think that means yes. How much damage does it do? 75 damage, and it's got 5 armor. That's gonna hurt. I can take it out, but that's gonna hurt. Maybe they won't shoot me. Surrounded on 3 sides by advanced automated 50 cal turrets is a glass cage. Inside, you can just barely make out a small green humanoid creature. It clutches a ragged baby doll while rocking back and forth. A bizarre, dead-eyed smile stretches across its broad face. What in the hell is wrong with this place? What happened here? And unless these things have very bad range, it doesn't look like they're gonna shoot me. Okay, I'm dead. Wait a minute. Something just screamed, but... No, okay, so we get the drop on the turrets? I mean, it did aim at me, so it is gonna shoot, right? Right? So I should start shoot... Yeah, it's gonna shoot. There's no way I can, like, reprogram them? That probably just unlocks that door. Okay. We need to kill these things before they start shooting. Because this is gonna hurt. So this is gonna be a burst moment. Good job. Let's move here, so... Yeah, I don't think that turret can shoot through the glass. It says side blocked, so yeah, let's move here. That way we're only in view of one turret. I don't need a burst fire. There we go. Out of commission. You know, now's the time for your energy weapon, actually. Yeah, let's pulse it. Beautiful! Did you just disable it? Oh no, but still did a lot. I'm thinking melee's not the best for this situation. I don't know, I just got a hunch. Okay. One more to go. Can we kill this thing before it has a chance to shoot? I wonder if it's gonna try to shoot through the glass and it's gonna, like, break it and ruin everything. Oh, your name is the Night Terror and you have 8,000 hit points. Good thing you seem to be friendly. Four turns. Can I do this? I think I can. Yeah, I think we can. Yeah, we totally can. I'm glad the game was nice enough to give us the drop on these turrets. Because normally the enemies would get to shoot first. Okay. There we go.
Copy, Echo. Congratulations, Echo.
Five points. I'll just save them for now. Let's see what they have on them. Turret targeting computer. Neat. It's actually kind of tough. Let's have you go it alone. Oh, crap. I just found a human heart in a box. It wasn't even refrigerated. Hi. I don't know what you are, but your name scares me. I wonder if I can talk to it before opening the door. I really don't want to open the door. I might kill it. I might get us killed. I don't know. But you know what? I'm realizing that this episode is already long, and there's obviously a lot more to this underground laboratory experiment place, whatever the hell this is. There's a lot more to it, so if I keep going, this episode's probably gonna end up being 2 hours. So I'll leave the mystery of what is up with the Night Terror for the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.